Hi everybody, so today I am going to record a get ready with me video. So as you can see, I've tied my hair back to start and I'm going to put on Urban Decay's Primer Potion. This will prime my eyelids to stop my eyeshadow from creasing and it should make my eyeshadows go on a lot more smoothly too. Okay, so this is a matte white eyeshadow from Stargazer and I'm just going to pop that onto my brow bone with a blending brush. This will kind of help the kind of gradual effect and, you know, as I put my crease colour on and then my lid colour so that it all just blends really well. 217 brush, and I'm using the colour Dark Horse from the Naked palette, which is a nice warm, just a nice fall colour. Popping that into my crease, as you can see, and I don't know if you can really tell from the video, but I'm, rather than connecting the outer corner of that brown to my lid, I'm kind of flicking it upwards to give like a winged shape and look to my eyeshadow. Just blending that in, and then I'm taking the brush I put my eyebrow highlight colour on with, and I'm just blending the top line so that there are no kind of harsh edges. I'm taking a 252 Sigma brush and the colour Half Baked. This colour is like a stunning gold colour and it almost looks like glitter on the lid, although it's just a shimmery kind of metallic colour. So that's going all over both eyelids on the space that is blank. Then I'm taking a small kind of pencil brush and I'm using the colour Dark Horse on the outer half of my lower lash line, which is the same colour that I used in my crease. And I'm just blending that along and kind of connecting it to the outside kind of shape of my eyeshadow. And then you will see me putting a colour in a minute, I think, on the inner half of my lid, and that is Half Baked, which is the gold that I put on the lid, just so that the colours like blend really nicely into each other under my lid. Okay, now I'm showing you the colour Virgin or Sin, I can't remember which. And I'm putting that right on my inner kind of tear duct area to brighten it up. Then I'm blending underneath my eye again. A lot of blending, but that's the best way to get a nice smooth look. Okay, 217 brush again, and I'm taking the colour Crepe, which is a kind of black sparkly shade. And I'm just going to pat a tiny little bit of that onto the outside V of my eye. I'm going to buff it inwards, and I'm not going all the way along the crease, I'm just kind of keeping it in the outer V of my eye, just to add a little bit of kind of depth and definition to the look. Then I'm taking a Stila smudge stick, and this is in the colour Damsel, which is just a really dark brown, and this is going to go in my waterline, and I'm also going to tightline with it as well. So that ugly piece of clip that you're about to see is me tightlining my eyes. This is my L'Oreal Super Liner, which is a black felt tip, like liquid eyeliner pen, which is so easy to use because it doesn't have like a brush and it doesn't splay, and it's just the easiest way that I find to apply eyeliner quickly. I love gel liner, but these are just so easy to grab and just do your liner with. So I've done a really thin line along the upper lid, really close to the lashes, then I've winged it out at the edge. Then I'm just thickening it up. Curl the eyelashes, are ready for mascara, which I do like later, so I don't know why I'm curling them now, but I'm a weirdo. And then I'm taking my Garnier under eye concealer job B thingy, and I look like a fool, and I'm just going to blend that in with my fingers, just kind of pat it underneath my eyes. This doesn't give a great deal of coverage, but it does give a light coverage, and it does make your eyes feel more awake and bright. And okay, this is number 7's Beautiful Skin BB Cream in the colour Fair. I'm going to pat this on my face with my fingers and blend it in with my fingers too. This is nice, but because it's a BB cream, it doesn't give the best coverage ever. And although it's the fairest colour, I think it might be a little bit too dark for me. But what can you do? I tried my best to blend it down my neck and stuff. Wasn't terrible. Okay, so blend that in, blend, blend, blend. And concealer, Lasting Perfection from Collection 2000, best concealer ever. Mine is in the shade Fair, which is the lightest one. And I'm just putting that on anywhere that I need it, which is a lot of places at the moment. And the reason I've put a little line along the tops of my cheekbones is because I actually get discoloration there. It goes a little bit yellow, so I just like to kind of conceal that a bit. So yeah, and I'm blending that with my fingers too. Okay, so foundation done, time to powder. This is the Pure Minerals Super Balance, I think. And this is like an amazing mattifying powder. It just keeps my skin looking matte all day. So I'm just putting that all over because I have oily skin, so I need to powder that bad boy down. And bronzer. This is Liz Earle's bronzer and I absolutely love this. I'm going to kind of bronze slash contour the face, kind of just to warm my face up really, no definitive contour or bronze, it's just kind of an in-between step, so that's what I'm doing here, and you can see the difference it just makes to my cheeks from one side to the other. Now I'm going to take my blush brush, and this is MAC's Peachy Keen Blush. My favourite blusher by MAC, I love this. And I'm just going to apply that along my cheekbones. I tend not to apply too much on the apple of my cheeks because I think it makes me look stupid. And I kind of... And this is a Shimmer Brick in Pink from Sue Moxley. And I'm applying that with the 188 from Sigma, which is what I applied my bronzer with. And it just gives a nice sheen to my cheekbones. This is my mascara. Now, I already put a coat on, but my camera cut out, so this is my second coat of mascara. And it's just a Body Shop mascara. And I poked myself in the eye a little bit there. I don't know if you saw me blink. What a fool. Okay, lips. This is MAC's Pretty Please lipstick, which is a very sheer satin kind of pinky nude shade. It's really sheer, and I'm just putting that on, and then I'm putting a little lip gloss over the top, and the gloss that I use is a Lip Venom gloss from, I think it's called Lip Venom, Doo-Wop, sorry. I'm not sure of the colour, but it's kind of like a nudie champagne colour. I'm just going to put a bit of that on with my finger over the top, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed. And I am done! Yay! So, a makeup video. It's been a very long time since I've done one. So I thought I would do the voiceover thing. Hopefully that worked out. It's probably not the best quality voiceover ever, but I'm using my webcam, so what can you do? So yeah, this is my kind of like a just casual... I kind of wear this kind of makeup day to day if I'm going out somewhere. But I mean, for a lot of people it's probably an evening look, and it's really simple, using a few colours from the Naked palette and a very simple lip. I'd say personally, to jazz up for the evening for me, I would add a lot more black in the outer corner and probably a brighter lip, but for day I would go out looking like this. Excuse the state of the lion's mane, it kind of is a little bit crazy. So yeah, I really really hope you enjoyed this video. It felt good to do, and maybe eventually I'll get back to actually talking properly throughout a whole makeup video, but I take a long time when I put my makeup on. I like to like enjoy it and
you know, just kind of go with the flow, and I feel like my videos would be really long, so yeah. Anyway, I hope you liked it. If you've got any requests, then leave me a comment, and yeah, I will see you all very soon.